wearing it so tight. Choosing your battles. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line. Everyone's watching. You know it's serious. We're getting closer. This isn't over. The pressure's on.
I'm sitting here with Lena, the famous DJ from Sip and Twirl, and we're going to talk a little bit about her past, her future, her Fire Island history. Like, tell me a little bit about when was your first trip to the Fire Island?
Oh, God. Not working. I was probably somewhere in the late 80s. I think it was in the late 80s, early 90s, yeah.
And what made you want a DJ? Like, how did this whole thing evolve?
Well, actually, it was Sean Patrick Ryan, when I was working here on the other side, who had approached me in the city, and he's like, you know, Lena, I think it would be fantastic if you came out here and started spinning. And at the time, you know, it was my agency from Paris, so I was going back and forth to Saint-Tropez and Sardinia in the summer, spinning between the two. So that's what my summers existed of. So, I mean, I hadn't been back out into the island since the time that I first came out. And it was also, it had changed so much, it had gone through a lot of metamorphosis and the whole, like, you know, AIDS thing and the drug thing in the 90s and whatever. A lot of people were pulling out and not really coming. So, of course, I didn't want to come, and it deterred me and any of my friends from coming out. So then I was like, you know what, let me just see what it's about. So I was like, you know, if anything, I can always go back to where I was, you know, in the summertime. And I came out, and I was booked just for one gig on a Saturday. It was for High Teen. It was the first time they'd ever had a DJ at High Teen, because before it was just a cassette player.
What year was that?
This was 2005. And then it just got so popular that then it became Lena's Lounge, and it got crazy. And then, of course, more gigs came upon that. And the next thing you know, I just moved out here, and do-do-do. So then I worked with them for 3 years on that side. And then moved over to where I'm doing Twirling now. It's a good Twirling PJ.
Let's see. What was your experience working on the other side years ago versus where you are now?
It was all beautiful. You know, I think any time that I'm, one, able to play music and make people happy and myself, is a good time. I think the more magical part about the first couple of seasons and the first season was just meeting all the people and just seeing how they interacted with me and my music and my love, and then receiving the love from them. So that in itself is just irreplaceable, and it's always going to have a special place in my box, and that's why this island is so special to me, and it continues to do so.
And did people know you when you started on this side?
Oh yeah, I mean, yeah, from my other life, you know, when I was a performer back in the day, but then there are people who just know me as a DJ for the last 16 years. And, you know, then at that time, before I'd come out here, I'd pulled away from the gay community, and I was working a lot in the straight communities and traveling a lot throughout Europe or whatever. So for the probably 2 years prior to coming out here, I was only doing like maybe one or two, you know, gay spots like Plaid and Spa. So other than that, it was pretty much straight places. So I think that a lot of them probably didn't get to see and know who I was, but a lot of them did.
What did Fire Island mean to you personally, and then also your career?
Beforehand or now?
Both.
Well, beforehand, I really hadn't had so much of a really connection to it, because I hadn't been out for so long. So it was kind of like I was really going into it blind, and now it just means everything to me. You know, the relationships of the friends and, you know, the work, everything, all of it is just, it's so magical to me. I mean, I spend 7 months of my life out here, and I love it. You know, aside from work, just, it's so beautiful, and it really is what you make it.
It is. And what did it mean to your career?
I think that, you know, just as in everything, I don't really like to put too much emphasis or too much anything into just one thing. I like to leave it into all of it. You know, and I really believe that it all kind of really adds and makes its own, at the end of the day, finished product as we go on through life. And I think that it's just become beautiful for all of the reasons, you know, from just being here and having beautiful people out here who really want to have a good time. And I think that at the end of the day, everybody's gonna walk away happy.
But isn't it sort of a, I guess a notch or a credit in your career, I played Fire Island as a DJ, doesn't it?
I guess. I don't think like that. I mean, you know, I think that that's also how my life has been, is that I really just take every day as if it's my last, obviously with caution and care, but I'm just happy and blessed to be doing what I want to do, you know, and that it brings so much joy to myself, importantly, and to everyone else. Because if I'm not getting off, you're not going to get off.
Yeah, I think that's a big, my view of your appeal is that it's, you are having a great time.
We're right there together.
It translates.
Yeah.
It absolutely translates right across the turntables or whatever. thing. And people rock. You know, they're rocking right with you.
It really is. It's like, it's really Wimbledon. It's like, I'm feeding off of them, they're feeding off of me, and it's just like, 40 love. You know what I mean? It's beautiful.
It is. So beautiful. And it helps you raise the bar with people like that. It helps you raise your DJ bar and, like, give them the music they want to hear and stuff like that. That was one of the questions. What do you think makes you successful at Sip and Swirl? Why, you know, it's this mass thing that people come up. It's this huge party that we're waiting for that deck to come tumbling down.
Well, honey, I'm going right with you.
We're all going down like the Titanic. But what do you think? How did that come about? Like,
I don't know. I mean, it had that vibe that, you know, when I was doing Lena's Lounge. I mean, the floor caved in upstairs. I don't know. I mean, when those people come out and they hear me spin, I think that what it is that they're finally having some type of personality with the DJ. With the DJ. You know, where it's all of us. So it's like, you know, when sometimes you go and, you know, you're hearing a set and the DJ's not moving. You know, they're just kind of like playing blindly to the, you know, to the masses, and they're not feeling the music. Well, I come from a dance background, so, you know, if I'm not dancing, you're not going to be dancing. So I've just got to feel it. And then, of course, you know, like I said, it's this vibe that just goes back and forth with me and the crowd.
I think vibe is really the word. That is,
and it's love. It's all love up in there.
That too.
You know, from the people, everyone who comes up and greets me and gives me some sugar,
yeah.
You know, it's like I know everyone's face. And some of those names, but it's just like, I know the faces and I know exactly where they are in the crowd. It's there. It's really there.